In this illustration, we'll see a situation of catching the train at a crossing. Here we are given that a railway track runs parallel to a road until a turn brings the road to a railway crossing. A cyclist rides along the road every day at a constant speed of 20 km per hour. He normally meets the train that travels in the same direction at the crossing. One day he was late by 25 minutes and met the train 10 km before the crossing. And here we are going to find the speed of the train. Here let's draw the picture of the situation to understand it better. Say this is the track of a train. And here is a railway crossing. And a track on road is running parallel to this railway track. Say at an instant, train is located at a distance x from this crossing, and here this is the train, which is say traveling at a speed vt. And at the same instant, say here there is a cyclist, which is located at a distance y from the crossing and traveling at a speed of 20 km per hour. It is given that the train which is traveling in the same direction of cyclist, they meet at the crossing. So that means the distance x traveled by train in a duration which is same in which the cyclist will travel the distance y. So we can write in general, as given, distance x divided by velocity of train is equals to y divided by 20. So this is our first equation. And we can write when cyclist is 25 minutes late, and we can convert this 25 minutes in hours, that is 25 by 60, that is 5 by 12 hours. If he is late by 5 by 12 hour, the cyclist will meet the train at a distance 10 km before the crossing. Say if this 10 km distance, somewhere here, the cyclist will meet the train. And as he is late by 25 minutes, that means in this 25 minute train would have traveled a distance of Vt multiplied by 5 by 12. In kilometers. So here we can write the time train will take in covering a distance from here to here is the time taken by cyclist in covering a distance y minus 10. So here we use this y minus 10 by 20 is equals to x minus 10 minus vt multiplied by 5 by 12 divided by Vt. So if we further simplify this expression, here you can see, and from here also we can use it. So on simplifying this, we are getting, substituting the values, this minus 1 by 2 is equals to minus 5 by 12 minus 10 by Vt. I've simplified these equations 1 and 2. And eliminated the values of x and y, and finally I'm getting this result in Vt. So further simplifying this, I can see this 10 by Vt is equals to 1 by 2 minus 5 by 12, that is 1 by 12. This means the velocity of train we are getting is 120 km per hour, that is the result of this problem.